Here in Georgia, Governor Kemp has ordered evacuations in six counties along the Georgia coast, and Atlanta's airport already feeling the effects of the hurricane.
CBS 46's Rebekka Schramm is live at Hartsfield-Jackson International. And this morning, Rebekka, you are seeing just a ton of cancellations across the board, right?
Yeah, Tracy and Gravier, good morning. Already we are seeing 1,300 flights across the country canceled for today alone, and that number continues to climb. Many of those flights are to and from coastal Florida. And yeah, as the hurricane continues to pound the Bahamas, the Palm Beach Airport closed at 2 o'clock this morning. It will likely reopen tomorrow. Also, Fort Lauderdale's airport will close at noon today until further notice. Orlando's airport was planning to close today, but it will now remain open, although some of its flights have already been canceled. In the meantime, the Red Cross volunteers are finding Atlanta to be a good hub for volunteers across the country to fly to. That way, they can be ready to jump into action once we get a better idea of which specific areas will be hit the hardest by Hurricane Dorian.
We at the Red Cross are closely watching the path of Hurricane Dorian and preparing to respond in Florida, many parts of Florida, and also in Georgia as well.
And as for airline travel, as you know, there is always a ripple effect whenever there is a natural disaster, of course, like a hurricane. So if you have a flight anywhere in the country today, you want to check with your airline to make sure that it is still on. We're live at Hartsfield-Jackson this morning. Rebekka Schramm, CBS 46 News. Yeah.